well, Mayo via retardo. Dawson, president me, made a peanut allergies. Retards at the Huff Pole. Kevin Smith's an asshole.
He's done 2,000 podcasts, and you keep complaining, anger never waning. He's done 2,000 podcasts, and you keep on going, cause it's hard, he's blowing.
Albert Brooks as best guest, Lynette kicked off Southwest. Molly, Philly, Big Mama got it all. Sunny and Natalia, not Taco Bell material. Olga, cheap calls, change smoking baby doll. No beer in first class, Dagas, Teddy, Pendergrass, DFT, not JV. What else do you want from me?
He's a 2,000 podcast, and you keep complaining, and you're never waiting. He's a 2,000 podcast, and you keep on going, cause his heart is glowing.
Dabble to Bungalow Sue, definitely not a Jew. Rich man, poor man, Bollywood, Kalen. Taxes, fair share, Jeff Ross, Rose Eisen, and the goalposts. Guinness record from Gervais, Celebrity Apprentice. Made up movie, favorite tweets, red bracelet for eating beets. Do his best, not your best, window of negligence. He sold out Seattle's more, mangrias in your liquor store. What can he complain about? Mom is chanting freak out.
Live from the Improv in Houston, Texas, in front of a socially distanced audience, this is the Adam Carolla Show. Adam's guest today, Kyle Dunnigan. With Bald Bryan on sound effects and Teresa Strasser filling in for news. And now, in Texas, because the CDC recommends staying 6 feet away from other people and as far as fucking possible from Los Angeles, Adam Carolla!
Yeah, get it on. Got to get it on. A choice, but get on mandate. Get it on. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for coming out tonight. I tried to pull the lid off the water back there and got a little premature. Hydration going. We're going to bring everyone up in a second. I just want to take a few minutes and talk to you guys before we start the official show. Thank you guys for coming out tonight. I do appreciate it. I got two things. Went out to dinner last night at Mastro's and had a steak. I really felt like I was in prison for the last 10 years. No, it really felt that way. It was just sitting in a booth, tomahawk, bone in, tomahawk, the martini, the guy was shaking at the table. By the way, could we agree on one shake for the martini? We had two martinis. We had one guy up here, the other guy was going the full... I'm gonna throw this at you and kill you. But had the martini, had the steak, had all the sides, had the desserts, had just watching people out in their natural habitat, being free and eating cows. And you know, coming from Los Angeles, that was a novelty, obviously. I think of it this way, and I think of it this way when it comes to the states that are locked down, which is, and it's a little bit of a, it's an example, but I think it's fitting, which is, when you do something, like when you injure yourself, like if you injure yourself snowboarding, your doctor will say, how did you break your ankle? And you go snowboarding. And then the doctor says, no more snowboarding for you. Which is fine if you're a dentist and you were just snowboarding over the weekend. But if you're a professional snowboarder, you're fucked. And so in California, our governor and our mayor of Los Angeles says, you broke your ankle snowboarding, no more snowboarding for you. But we say we make our living snowboarding, and we have a tournament coming up in 6 weeks. And he goes, I don't care, hit the sofa. In other states, in other cities, they say, you broke your ankle snowboarding. We're going to put a plate and some screws in it, but we'll have you up on the mountain in 10 days, and you can compete. Because it's your fucking choice whether you hurt yourself snowboarding again. And that's how you feed your goddamn family. So my thing is, don't tell me never to do this thing ever again. Tell me how long it's going to take to safely get me back up on the mountain, which doesn't mean I won't break my fucking ankle again. It just means I get to die trying. Anyway, I was eating a steak last night. I got a massage today. I didn't know the massage was on the table. I didn't know. I was like thinking of shit I could do when I went to Texas and I had get a haircut, eat a steak, get my eyebrows waxed, go to a lens crafter and get a new prescription for glasses. These are all lofty goals when you're from Los Angeles. I get to go to a lens crafter's and stand in line. This is fucking huge. But I was walking around yesterday in between getting the eyebrows waxed and getting a haircut, and I saw massage places that were open. And I was like, I don't know how this works, but I'm in. So I went into the massage. By the way, there is no difference between the highfalutin four-star hotel massage and the strip mall massage. The only difference is $60, and it's going in your fucking pocket. And a chick that's trying a little harder to please. So I went in and got myself a strip mall massage, and I gotta tell you this, when a 56-year-old Asian woman says to do something, I do it. She's like, get naked and get on that table. And I was like, okay. She's like, first, you clean the bathroom, round eye. And I'm like, okay. She went full bare buttocks. I've never had this before. She pulled the sheet off. She got on the table with me. I've never had that before. Cirque du Soleil shit. She fucking was on the table and she was kneading my ass like cornbread, like she was gonna put it in the oven, like she was working it. And she, I don't know if she's Vietnamese or Taiwanese, I don't know if she was, but she wasn't from an ass hair centric community. Like my ass, the hair on my ass was probably more than the last 750 guys she dealt with combined. Like, she was kneading my hairy ass. She had her knee in between my legs. I had like some weird, it wasn't a back sack situation. It was a below bottom sort of half Nelson sack situation she was dealing with. And she told me to flip over, but didn't offer me the towel. She's like, just flip you now, flip over. And I'm like, okay. And I flipped over and I pulled the towel over myself gingerly. She was working on my ass. It felt good. I had the haircut, had the brow wax, had the steak last night, had the full rub, minus the tug. I don't know, though. See, my feeling is I don't like the rub and tug, but I would take the tug and rub. My thing is, let's get it over with, and then let me relax and get a massage. I'd like to flip the script on the elderly Asian women there. Let's see. Let me see what I had written down here. Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. Shall we, Max Pata, shall we bring in our guests? We have...
We have Bryan and Teresa.
We have Bryan and Teresa. Bryan and Teresa. Great to see you guys. Kyle will join us post-haste. Where's everyone out? Bryan, where are you at now?
I'm still in La Quinta, the Palm Springs area of California. It's hot. It's like 96 degrees here today, but nice to get some pool action in.
And Teresa, where are you at?
I'm out in Phoenix, Arizona, and I just wanted to say, Adam, it's not just that you are eating a steak, but you are helping some people in need out there in Houston, because the show that you're doing tonight and all of your shows in Houston benefit the Houston Food Bank. And I know you won't say it, so I just wanted to say thank you for that.
Right. So all the money, all the proceeds from this weekend's shows are going to the Houston Food Bank, where... It's good, but you're probably not getting the steak I got last night. You're probably getting a dented can of Dinty Moore stew.
And but, you don't get to choose whether your tug comes before your rub.
Right. Yeah.
Dry rub on that steak.
Yeah, dry rub. I never had the even potential for the rub and tug. I didn't know what to think. I was like, oh my God, is this happening right now? I don't know what etiquette is. I can't get to my wallet from here. My foot was like trying to get to my pants. I didn't know. Have you guys ever come close to a rub and tug or something that was a massage? Like I had a friend who went to a chiropractor and the guy dropped a digit on him. Yes. Well, the problem, here's the problem with dropping the digit or the rub and tug. You think, well, that's insane. I would never go for that. Or I would pay extra for that. But either way, you don't think it would happen to you, but that's you standing fully dressed, like eating breakfast and talking to a friend. Now you're naked and you're face down on a pillow and your face is through a donut that's at the end of the pillow and you're fully naked and a stranger you've never seen before has lubed you up with grease and is working your loins. Now you seem a little closer to that outcome. Teresa, is that anything like that ever happened to you?
Okay, I just have to admit something. I don't usually watch a lot of porn, but quarantine has been, you know, it's tough times.
Right.
And I did see this in a porn recently.
Oh.
Where the woman was getting a massage and the massage therapist gave her a very special massage. And I will say that I thought about it later. It was a good scene.
Uh-huh.
Porn-teen.
Yeah. I've seen that. Bryan, anything for you? Anything come close for you?
Never had the pleasure. No, I did have the remember you mentioned the woman got on the table with you? I did have a massage once, a very exotic massage, where the Japanese woman, it was a Japanese massage parlor, I have to assume she was Japanese, got up on me, stood on me, and like held a bar like above herself to like walk on my back. Like her support, her whole 120 pounds wasn't on my back, but she was holding a bar walking on my back.
I walked into the room where I was going to get the massage and I saw the bar on the ceiling and I took it to be a good omen. Because it was sort of like those bars they use for the veterans to rehab on the ceiling. And I thought, is she going to use this bar? So I did happen to notice that, although it didn't look like OSHA had approved this. It was a 2x4 on its edge with a couple of like dowels you'd have at a cheap motel in the closet, and that was across like but maybe Maybe it's what you want. Maybe it's like a fail safe. Like heavyweights need not apply to this job.
Right.
Like it'd be good for, you know, because when the plus size gals come in and they go, hey, I'd like a job at the rub and tug. I'm sorry, the ceiling would cave in, Hefty. We really wish we could accommodate you, but the whole shit house would come down if you got up on that table. The table's rated to 375 pounds. Our average guess is 175. You're going 2 1/4. Clearly the math is not gonna work. So I guess the point is if you want to get yourself a little bit more than a massage, you must go to a massage parlor that's in a strip mall and that has other weird businesses next to it. If you go to a freestanding place, you're in a hotel or at a Burke Williams or something like that, this place, the business next to it was sushi, and on the other side of that was like a pet store. So you knew.
Oh no.
You knew you were in for a good time. All right. Should we bring Kyle in? Where is Kyle? Can we pot him up? And Max Paddock, can we bring down my my monitor just a little bit? That would be good. Kyle.
Hey, it's I took over. I'm doing Kyle's Zoom today.
Sorry, that's Cuomo.
Mayor Cuomo. Yeah. Or Governor Cuomo.
Governor Cuomo.
What are you people doing there? What is this?
Hey, Governor Cuomo, we're in Texas. I'm doing a live show.
So what?
I got on an airplane.
The virus knows no borders, okay? Do you understand this? The virus doesn't care where the forefathers drew lines, okay? It travels through the air, you see?
Right. I traveled through the air to get to Texas. We wanted to come here and do a live show with the people. I know I'm not wearing a mask right now. I just feel like it's important at some point to open up the economy and to get out there and speak with the people.
Look, it's foolish. Look, I was listening to you, okay? I hear your analogy about the snowboarder. It's a very simple solution, okay? The snowboarder, okay, just needs to go to one of his bank accounts, take out a few $100,000, and just be on vacation for a few months.
Right, but see, so my example, Governor Cuomo of New York, is I'm a professional snowboarder. I don't have enough money to retire, so I need to get back up on the slopes. Now, it's never going to be without risk. I need to mitigate the risk and then get out there and compete again because that's my livelihood.
Okay, so you have no money as a snowboarder, yes?
Right.
Then what you do is you go to your parents. And you say, give me a few $100,000 to get me through these months. Capisce?
Yeah, okay. I'm Italian, but a lot of people don't know what capisce means. But it's like it means you understand. But see, I think you're playing it too safe when you lock down the city of New York for month after month. I think a place like Texas did it right. They have their social distancing.
You people shut your mouths. Listen, by the power of the state of New York, I command all of you to get up and leave. There is, Adam, listen to me. Yes. Listen to me. I have arranged a freezer truck. We are going to freeze the whole audience for 2 years until we have a cure.
Right, but Governor, you understand, first off, you don't have jurisdiction over Texas. I know you have jurisdiction. Here's the problem with New York and with Los Angeles. The folks that run those governments feel like they speak for the entire nation. You don't know that there's a whole group of people that aren't on the coast that make their own decisions and do what they believe is right for them and their family. You can't command Texas to do what you want to do just because you're from New York.
Yes. Next question.
Oh, you're pass?
He passed on the question, yeah.
I'm passing on the question. Oh, okay. Yes. I pass.
Look, everybody is social distancing. Everyone is being responsible. The one time where the Asian woman was crawling on my back earlier today. Other than that,
we have quarantined her. She is in our custody at this moment. Your Asian masseuse.
You found her in quarantine?
Yes, we have her here. She is frozen. Yes.
I know your brother's a beloved news anchor on CNN, and I understand you guys have an opinion that's probably different than many others in the country, but I feel like you should be able to live and let live. You should understand that not everybody subscribes to your particular type of governing.
This, look, New York and California, that is America. Okay, these middle things, that's just the middle. You know what I'm saying? It's like the Oreo cookie. You ever have one of those? You open it up, you have the two sides, okay? You lick out the middle, the trash, and then you have the nice cookie, the New York and the Los Angeles. Capiche?
Yeah, see, you sound like an elitist when you say that. You sound like a double stuff elitist when you say that. You have to understand what you think of is flyover country. Other people think of it as their home.
Oh, that's, look, wait a minute. Where'd I go? Hold on a second. Wait a minute.
You look great, Governor.
Who is this? This guy's hot.
Ow!
Oh, there I am. Oh, disgusting. Here is. Look, it's very simple. Without the New York and the California, there's no America. There is just a big trash heap landfill in the middle.
But see, this is the elitism. This is why Donald Trump is president. You guys.
Hey, be quiet. You shut your mouths in there.
Well, you didn't realize there are other people in this country and they vote. And it's not just about the coast. It's not.
Those people are waiting to get into New York. Those people are waiting to get into California.
No, but what's happening now, with all due respect, is people are fleeing New York and they're fleeing California because they don't like the oppression of those places. They want to go somewhere where the cost of living is cheaper, where they can go out and make their own decisions, where they can go to a strip mall and get half a rub and tug and not have the governor or the mayor telling them how to live their life. There are people that are fleeing New York, Governor.
You are now under arrest, sir. I believe you know the law of yelling fire in a theater. You have yelled nonsense in a comedy club, and you are under arrest.
We're not in a coffee club. We're at the Houston Improv. We're safely distancing.
Look at those two in the front row. Look at, this is an example. Look at these two.
These two?
There's two bikers in the front row.
They're not bikers.
There's two dirty people. They've got every disease. Look at these people. This is who you hang out with.
I don't think they have diseases. They don't, they look very robust and healthy to me.
I don't think you can make that. Yeah, you're not even there.
They have I bet you $1 million they have a bike and they don't wear helmets because F the man is their attitude.
Oh, that there's no helmet laws in Texas. Oh, my God.
Because you all have brain damage. That's the problem over there.
Governor, you would not be good in Texas. They have a no subway system and no helmets. These guys just ride their motorcycles. They're free to make their own decisions about their safety.
Listen, in 2 weeks, that whole audience will be dead with COVID.
This guy.
Well, don't have to worry about it.
This guy's got himself a mini pitcher of beer. According to my calculations, he could have just ordered 2.5 beers, but instead, he got a mini pitcher of beer, and he's pouring his own beer, and he's in charge of pouring his own beer, and he has a little something called beer sovereignty, and that's the way he likes it.
You peoples, you stop your clapping. You stop your clapping, and you worship Andrew and Chris Cuomo.
Now, are you a single? Are you a single man, right?
Yeah. And I get kinky. I got the nipple rings.
You have nipple rings.
Yeah, I like to get the playful in the bedroom. If you know what I mean. Yeah.
I did not know that about you.
Little tug and tickle.
Oh yeah. Are you single? Are you divorced? Well, you have children? What's your status?
I'm single. Ready to mingle, not with any of the trash there in that room.
He's gone full heel.
I'm going heel, Adam.
Yeah, but these people, I know you disagree with them politically, but after all, we're all Americans, and I know you want what's best for them after all.
That's true. Okay. I got a little excited. I'm sorry. Okay.
All right, maybe we could talk to Sylvester Stallone, because I feel like Sylvester Stallone is a Los Angelino, or at least that's where he resides.
And hey,
I know that Stallone.
That's right.
Stallone wishes he could get out and have a tomahawk steak and a rub and half a tug. Am I right?
That's right, Adam. Let's go out and do this. Who was that last jerk? Huh?
You're cooped up there in Beverly Hills. It's going on month 3. Are you working on a movie, The Expendables 4?
Yeah, we're doing The Expendables 19. And we added the movie Drive to it. I told you about this. We're doing Drive into the Expendables 19.
Right. We're doing the Drive, and then I think the movie you're thinking about is The Expendables. You keep saying
The Expendables 19.
No, you're on
even more Expendable. Is the log line.
You're doing The Expendables 4, not The Expendable. It's COVID 19. It's not The Expendable 19.
Yeah, I get confused. You know, there's so many numbers coming at me, you know?
Right. So you're doing The Expendables 4.
Expendables 4, yeah.
Yeah, we're on Rocky. I don't know what anymore. What Rocky are we on?
We're on 62.
We're on Rocky.
Yeah. The next script, Rocky tries to move some furniture. He's doing less and less stuff as he gets older, you know?
So we got Rocky, then we got Rambo.
Yeah, Rambo is moving into an old age home, and there's some spies from Russia that he's got to defeat. But he's got to defeat him in a game of bridge.
So Rambo's going to play Russian spies in an old age home in a game of bridge.
Yeah, and there's a nap in the middle of the movie. Remember they used to have those intermissions in the movies?
Yeah.
Intermissions. We're going to have that in Rambo 52. A little nap in the middle.
Well, I know, last time I saw you, were at Maria Menounos' house.
Angelina Jadudos, right there by the hot tub, right?
Maria Menounos, right?
Regina Frattuto's house, yes.
Right. Her name is Maria. That's a common name, you know?
Mamina Mamounos.
Yeah, Sly, I think the problem is you run them together. You know, you go Maria Menounos. But if you just said Maria, pause, Menounos, I think you could do it. Try it.
Maria, pause, Menounos.
No, but don't. I'm sorry. Let's try this again.
All right, let's do this. I like when we do things together, okay, you know? You're the captain, and I'm your Gilligan.
Right. Yeah. Maria.
Maria, pause, Menounos.
Maria, pause, Menounos.
Marina, pause, Menounos.
Yeah, but don't say pause.
All right, don't say pause. Well, why'd you say pause? That's just pissing me up, you know?
You start saying words,
you're telling me to say words, but you're saying different words.
Okay, Sly, I'm sorry. I don't upset you, but hey, I'm
get me all riled up here.
It out loud. It's like when someone says, repeat after me, right? You don't say, repeat after me, you see?
Repeat after me.
Yeah, but don't. When I say pause, you pause, but you don't say pause.
Okay, I got a boss. All right.
Maria, pause, Menounos.
Regina, Menounos.
Okay. Well, that was pretty close. So.
How about that pause?
No, don't say pause.
How about though? Did pretty good that time, I think.
Pretty good.
You definitely paused.
Definitely. See that, Bryan knows.
That was pretty good. So when we were at Maria Menounos' house, I was talking to you a lot. I didn't know that you had, Sly has horses. He races horses. He rides horses. He and his wife.
Make love to the horses.
No, 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 you said you loved horses. You
big love to the horse, yes.
That is not what you said. You said you loved horses, that you and your wife loved horses.
Oh, we do. Yes.
But not that you made love to the horses.
Yeah, whatever you want to call it, boss.
Now, we're talking a little earlier about Donald Trump, and I know that Cuomo and Trump probably don't see eye to eye on many issues, and Trump's probably a little more in the corner. Pardon me, when I say the corner, I'm talking till Sylvester Stallone. I don't know whose corner are you in? You in Trump's corner or Cuomo's corner?
Well, let me be honest with you. I don't really follow the news, if you can believe it. And I don't really read anything. So I'm in Rocky's corner, you know? Just don't mess with me. That's my philosophy.
So you don't watch the news and you don't read?
I don't know who you're talking about, to be honest.
Well, the president is Donald.
Of what?
Huh?
You said president. I say of what? What president of what? You know, there's many kinds of presidents, you know? President of this company, president of that company. You know, which one? I ain't stupid.
I should be more clear. The president of the United States of America is Donald J. Trump.
Oh, the guy from the, okay, yeah.
Yeah.
From The Apprentice.
Yeah, he's from The Apprentice. He's now.
That guy's president.
He's hard to imagine.
Whoa, when this? Well, all right.
It's been well over 3 years now.
Well, you know, I've been doing my movies, working out. It's hard to stay up to date on current events, you know.
Yeah, I get you're not staying up on current events, but I feel like you should know who the president is.
Well, I do now, boss, don't I? Ronald Trump.
Got you there.
Donald Trump is the president of the United States.
Beautiful. Congratulations.
Yeah, okay. He had the most people attend his inauguration more than any other president that came before him.
All right.
Yeah. So.
Sounds like he's doing pretty good.
Yeah, he's doing pretty good. So scandal-free so far. He's just been sort of sailing.
That's what you like.
Sailing through the first 3.5 years, and he's turning the corner and looking at 4 more. So the reason... The reason you probably never heard of him is he's been kind of laying low and just flying under the radar. You know,
taking care of business. Yeah.
I like that. He's a quiet type, keeping to himself, doing his job. I like that.
Right. He's all business. He's not one of these blowhards that's sitting up on Twitter all night. He's a little camera shy. He'd rather push the experts out front while he's sort of in the back quietly making policy. So I we forgive you, Sly, for not knowing that he's the president of the United States. But
just didn't catch it, that's all. Yeah. Got it now.
Now, he's running against Joe Biden. You know Joe Biden?
No, I do not, sir.
Okay. He was the vice president.
Of what? You keep doing this.
I'm sorry. I'm not being clear.
No.
Okay, I'm sorry. When I speak about the president or the vice president, I'm always speaking of this country. I'm not speaking of Manila.
McDonald's or something.
He was the vice president of the United States. Barack Obama, you remember?
Who is?
Huh?
Who?
Barack Obama.
What's a Barack? What's a Barack Obama? What is that?
He was a president for 8 years of this country.
8 years?
Yeah.
I didn't catch that one.
All right. I feel like he made some news in this. He was the first African-American president this country has ever had.
We have a black guy?
Yeah.
Oh, how'd that happen?
I know it kind of caught me off guard, too, but I made adjustments, and it was fine. But he was... 8 years. He was a two-term black president of the United States.
Two-term. That's like 4 weeks. What is that?
No, it's 4 years each term. So he was 8 years.
Yeah, well, let me get a pen. Hold on. You're talking crazy numbers right now. All right, go ahead.
So he was president first term, 4 years.
First term, 4 years, four years. Right.
And then we reelected him, and so he went another 4 years.
4 years, reelected him 4 years.
Right, so when you take those two numbers and you combine...
Two plus two, okay.
No, it's 4 plus 4.
4 times 4, that's like 26.
No.
26 years.
Fly.
I missed this guy. Can't believe it.
He was black, but he wasn't really Carl Weathers black.
No, he wasn't Clubber Lang black.
He wasn't Clubber Lang black. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, okay, I get what you're saying. He was like that Will Smith black.
Yeah, that's right. He was a
kind of well put.
He was a slightly lighter, slightly less in a weird way black than the Clubber Lang or Apollo Creed type black. May have been a little. He wasn't whiter than Drago, but he was somewhere between Drago and Clubber Lang.
Like if Clubber Lang had butt sex with Drago. Their baby's Barack Obama?
It's been said every time.
That makes sense to me in my head. That makes sense to me when you say it.
No, it's accurate when you think about it. If as long as you got your scratch pad out, I think you could probably figure out that Clubber Lang and Drago, they had a child, could be a President Obama.
I'm crunching the numbers here, you know. I'm crunching the numbers, and that's what I'm getting.
Right. So that was the last 8 years, and then we've had 3.5 years of Donald Trump.
All right. I think I'm up to date now. Thank you.
Up to date. And then Joe Biden was Obama's vice president.
All right. Here we go. Okay.
So he was vice president for 4 years.
Here you go with these numbers again. All right.
Now he's running for president. So he could be the president after about a half year when we vote again.
All right. What does this audience think? Who does this audience want?
They don't like Joe. They don't like Joe. Maybe, I don't know, is President Trump around there in your house somewhere?
Yeah, actually, I think he might be somewhere in my house. Hold on a second. Where is this guy?
Maybe look at this. God. Let me get my hair on.
Get your hair on.
Oh, yeah. This is my COVID-19 hair. Just letting it go. What's up, people? Fuck that Cuomo guy, right?
Yeah, President Trump, thanks for joining us. Yeah, Andrew Cuomo says he doesn't think it's safe for me to be in Texas or out on stage. He doesn't like people showing up without
wearing. Yeah, he's a pussy. Total double loser pussy. Him and his brother, a couple of Cuomo sexuals.
You're calling them Cuomo sexuals?
Yeah, they're doing butt stuff, those two. Believe me.
Now, there's a lot of, obviously, controversy swirling around. You hear the term, I hear you talking about Obamagate all the time. I don't know exactly.
Yeah, you know what it is. Believe me, you know what it is. Obamagate. So terrible. So terrible.
Right. But a lot of people don't know what it is. So could you explain?
They know. You know what it is. That's all. You know. Okay. That's it. Obamagate. So terrible.
President Trump, forgive me, but you would be a horrible math teacher because the student would be like, I don't know how to work this equation out. And you would say,
do it, you stupid idiot.
Right. So we keep saying, what is Obamagate? And you keep saying, you know what it is. But
you know what it is.
Right.
You know, it's Obamagate. So terrible. You know Watergate, right?
Yeah.
Heard of this. Okay. So that's Obamagate. You got the gate. Terrible. Right. Then you've got the water. Okay, water's nice. But the Obama and the gate, double terrible. So terrible.
Right. So Watergate was the scandal with Nixon. And now we have another scandal called Obamagate. And we just take in exactly. Obama's last name and put it with gate.
That's right. Two terrible things make quadruple terrible. Right, folks? See, they know Obamagate.
All right, they know Obamagate. A president, you want to stick around? Well, Teresa Strasser will do some news, and you can kind of jump in and, you know, crack wise and hang out, give your opinion.
Sure. Whatever you want.
Can we do a little of that? Oh, we're doing blah, blah, blog? Oh, sorry, I didn't know that. Sorry, we're going to do blah, blah, blog first. Sorry.
It's time for blah, blah, blog. The game where we match the celebrity with their retarded online rant. Let's play.
We should point out to the audience that back in the day when we started this game, Teresa Strasser was just unbeatable. She was a legend of this game.
Yeah, but now I'm more like Sylvester Stallone. Like, I'm in the convalescent home playing Mahjong. I think I've lost my stuff, but we'll see.
All right, let's see if she still has her fastball. Go ahead, dog.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with being Sylvester Stallone, Teresa, you know? Pretty
Sorry.
Great to be me.
All right, Sorry. This is an all-pandemic edition of Blah Blah Blog. It's not the time for denial. We must take this seriously and shelter in place. It's time for nesting, reading, cleaning out closets, doing something you've always wanted to do. Write a book, learn an instrument, or a language, or learn to code online, draw, or paint. Going through photos, cooking, and reconnecting on a deeper level with the people you love. I find hope in the generosity, love, protection, and care I see and feel going throughout our country every day. And my heart goes out to everyone directly affected or simply in fear. We will get through, and I bet you our humanity will shine like never before.
Okay, this is a total loser.
Is it Gwyneth Paltrow?
Gwyneth Paltrow.
Reese Witherspoon?
Reese.
Or Alyssa Milano?
Oh.
The three-headed monster.
Three-headed monster. I don't want to tell you how to construct your blog, but... do not bookend, clean out your closet, or things you've always wanted to do. Get a little daylight between clean out your closet and do things you've always wanted to do. No one has always wanted to clean out their fucking closet. And by the way, most people don't have a closet that you use a zip line to go through. Most people have a fucking closet that resembles a closet. So I could clean out my closet in 14 minutes, not alphabetize my shoe collection, but okay. This is pablum. This is this new world order. I don't know what's going on. What happened to people where they just fucking talk and nothing comes out of their mouth? Nothing. That was three paragraphs of fucking zilch meets jack shit. Thank you, independently wealthy person, for schooling up the poor people on what we could do with our fucking closets or learn to play flamenco guitar. It's tough because they all talk about nothing with great certitude. I'm going to say Gwyneth.
Yeah, sometimes it's obvious. So I'm going to go with Gwyneth also. The nest thing jumped out to me, nesting or whatever.
Yes.
You know, I may have lost my stuff, but staying with the baseball metaphor, they say that she was born on third and thought she hit a triple. I'm going with Gwyneth as well.
Right.
Hey, Adam.
Hmm.
Have you seen Alyssa Milano lately?
Yeah, she's 47, but she's...
Who's the boss? Apparently donuts.
Donuts are her
fat
mom.
Now.
No,
that's right. Her boss is donuts.
She's an attractive woman. Come on, Trump. You, by the way, you're morbidly obese. You can't be.
Oh, I look good. That's muscle.
Nancy Pelosi said you're morbidly obese. You can't be making fun of Alyssa Milano's weight.
But she's a girl. They're supposed to be tidy.
Wait a minute. You're saying men can be morbidly obese, but women can't be more than 4% body fat?
Men can be morbidly obese. Women have to starve.
Wow.
Those are the rules. I didn't make them up.
All right. No, I get it. You're just playing by them. You didn't.
You're so judgmental right now, Adam.
Okay. Jeez. I'm just saying. I'm looking for clarity.
God. Hurt my feelings.
But and do you have any words for Nancy Pelosi, who called you morbidly obese?
She's like a skeleton, that lady. She looks like she's dead.
All right.
Skeleton arms.
Did you pick Alyssa Milano?
Yeah, I picked a fat girl.
Okay. All right. I don't think she's fat, but okay. Two Gwens, or three, is it three Gwens? One Alyssa Milano. Here we go.
The blog belongs to Gwyneth Paltrow.
Yes. Donald, you ever go on her webpage, Goop?
Yeah, I go on there to jerk off.
Well, I wasn't thinking about that. I was thinking about...
I was just being honest. Jeez.
Oh, Adam, what do you think?
Tonight.
No. What do you think he goes on there for?
Yeah,
what am I reading? Something interesting? Come on. I go there for the side boob.
Yeah, no, you're definitely known for your candor. You know what candor means, right?
Yeah, candor. That's when, what does candor mean?
No, it means you're honest. You speak honestly.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Shoot from the hip.
Yeah, right.
Sure. Right.
Right. Okay. Next one, Dawson.
I think that fear can spread so much hatred, and fear can spread so much negativity, and fear can spread the disease even quicker than the disease can. When I got back to L.A., I noticed that the fear was heightened here. So I wanted to empower everybody, and I wanted to let you guys know that we have the power. You have the power. You have the power to eliminate fear. Is it Brie Larson, Ariana Grande, or Lizzo?
Oh, boy. That would be quite a spin of the roulette wheel, would it not, President?
Oh, my God. Look at this group here. No fun whatsoever be had with these girls.
Yeah, I know Lizzo. I've seen her twerking on the beach. You see her twerking, President?
I didn't see that, thank God.
I know you and I, Donald, are a little old-fashioned. We prefer Thin Lizzy to Fat Lizzo. Is that correct?
Yeah. Where's Thin Lizzo? This girl looks like she takes monster dumps, right, Adam?
It would be hard to argue.
I'm wrong.
Yeah. So, ironically, the girl next to her, whose last name is Grande, is giving away 180 pounds to a.
That's what I was talking about.
But all right, so we have Captain Marvel over there. Is she Miss America? What is she?
Captain Marvel, you got it.
Yeah, all right, so we have
fake
her.
Fake hero.
Okay.
Girls
well,
can't
I loved
be
her in Room, and Room is very relevant now since we're all trapped in one.
That's true.
Yeah, I did like her in Room.
Now,
just a woman locked in a shed. I love that movie.
She is a wild blowhard. She is an insane narcissistic blowhard.
Insufferable.
Insufferable blowhard. I don't think Lizzo talks quite... Well, by the way, what you just heard is a fucking hamper full of nothing. So, by the way, I like that fear spreads the disease faster than the actual virus spread. I hope none of these... witches ever try to pilot an airplane, although Captain Marvel did in a movie.
It's true.
I'm going to say I'm going with Brie Larson because she's such a blowhard.
I feel like, based on nothing, that Lizzo would have a theme of like live without fear, live without fear. So I'm going to say Lizzo.
Yeah. Oh, Lizzo? Okay. Yeah.
I'm also going to go with Brie. I don't think it's Lizzo. I follow her on Instagram. She keeps it pretty light with a lot of pictures of her booty and not that much fear talk.
Shit.
They're all pretty intolerable. We got big poops there. We got bad picking men guy, lady there. I'm going to go with that Brie Larson, too. Just an insufferable, disgusting, gross fake superhero Brie Larson. Okay.
The blog belongs to Lizzo.
Woo!
Oh, damn it.
I knew it.
Got it, Bryan.
Sorry.
Wow.
I thought I didn't steer you wrong. It was 100% that bitch.
All right. What do we got? I got one.
Walt has two. Adam and Teresa have one. Donald Trump has zero.
Oh, hey. Come on, Trump, sir. Here we go.
Rigged. Fake game.
Wait, you're saying it's...
Hope y'all are staying safe. Spread love and kindness. Not Rona. Is it Will Smith, Jussie Smollett, or Gabrielle Union?
Wait a minute. We're spreading love and not what?
Rona.
What's
Rona?
The Rona.
Oh. Are we COVID-19? Are we Corona? Hey, Donald Trump, what do you like to call her? Are you a China? You Wuhan? What's your thing?
Yeah, the Chinaman disease. That's what I call it.
You don't,
pretty accurate.
You don't go COVID-19?
No, what the hell's that?
Oh, no, that's what everyone's calling it now, the coronavirus, COVID-19.
Look, it came from China, the China virus. A man started it, China man virus. Okay, that's it. Very accurate.
But what about that poor Chinese reporter who was talking to you about it, and you kept saying China to her, don't you? Were you saying that because she was Chinese?
Yeah, I like to lean in when they're Chinese, and I go, you're Chinese. You're from China. Scares them. They scare easy. Remember that Godzilla movie? They get all scared and run around. It's hilarious.
All right, so we got Will, we got Jesse, and who's the third? Oh, Gabrielle Union. Oh,
Gabrielle Union.
She's pretty blowhardy. But this is pretty simple. But what's Jussie Smollett doing in this group? I'm going Gabrielle Union. No, wait. Will Smith. I'm changing to Will Smith.
Well, you may want to change it again because I'm going Will Smith. He always he's just so uncontroversial. He just wants to say the most vanilla, ironically, vanilla thing ever. So I'm saying Will Smith.
Will Smith.
I'm with you in terms of your reasoning, but I thought calling it Rona might be too lighthearted for Will Smith. I think he, never wanting to be controversial, would try to maybe have a little more gravitas. So I'm going to go Gabrielle Union.
Donald Trump, Gabrielle Union says she was fired from America's Got Talent because she was a black woman. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, probably. What's the controversy?
No, the controversy is she was fired because she's a black woman.
Right. Yeah, that checks out.
No, but I think you're kind of missing the point. The controversy is that she was fired because she was a black woman.
Okay, I'm hearing two things. She was fired because she's black. Okay, that's one thing, makes sense. And then you're saying this other word, controversy, which isn't sort of connecting with me. Okay.
Well, no, what I'm saying is if you have a job and you're fired because you're not doing your job, that's not controversial. But if you're fired because of the color of your skin, that's controversial.
By the way, Carosa accused you of doing just that, President.
She's a bitch. Look, I love black. I love the blacks. I love the whites. I love the Chinese. But if she's in this competition and she was being black and she got fired, that happens. That's all I'm saying. I'm not on either side. Both sides good. Both sides, okay. Good people.
But no, she wasn't being black. She is black. That's
right. Well, that's being black, isn't it?
Well, I guess so, but I'm saying
it's okay, true. Solved. End of conversation. This is over. Okay. Moving on.
In the morning, she's black. She doesn't go into work and become black. That's what I'm saying.
Okay. Okay. So she should be fired from home, is what I'm hearing from you.
Okay. All right. Do you have a guess, Mr. President?
I'm going to go with Will Smith. He's raised the most insufferable children. So he would say something terribly ignorant like this tweet.
That's true. His kids did grow up quite different than I did.
Good Lord.
All right.
The
Dawson.
Blog belongs to Jussie Smollett.
Oh!
Tricked us. Sneaky.
Hey, President Trump, are you familiar with that story where he was there in Chicago and he accused a couple of guys wearing MAGA hats that came up to him?
Yeah. What a loser. I mean, I kind of respect how audacious the lie was. Pretty sweet. But total loser.
You're saying you're complimenting him on his lie?
Well, think about it. It's pretty cool. I mean, put that noose around his neck or something, right?
Right.
I mean, it's crazy. Crazy story. And yeah. He went for it. I respect that. He went for a ridiculous, stupid lie, and I respect that. Okay?
Okay. And he said the assailants were wearing MAGA hats.
Yeah, awesome. MAGA rules.
All right.
Gets $5 for every cap sold.
Oh, do you? All right.
$5.
Do you have some sort of foundation, a charity?
Yeah. Yeah, the Donald Trump Foundation goes right to my fucking wallet.
I'm sorry, you give the money to what foundation?
Me, the Donald Trump Foundation, my wallet.
Okay. All right, let's do one more, Dawson.
Look, what am I going to do, give it to starving kids? There's too many people. This is a natural thing.
When they put Wuhan, China in quarantine, they were spraying shit in the streets. They were knocking on each door, taking people's temperature. Let's say that I have the coronavirus right now, okay? How am I supposed to know I got it? Is it Vanessa Hudgens?
That's it.
That'll get it.
Cardi B.
Loser.
Or Rosie O'Donnell.
Oh, gross.
Boy, that is another tough wheel spin, isn't it, Donald Trump?
Rosie O'Donnell looks like what Elvis would look like if he lived.
I know.
Looks like Elvis.
I know you and Rosie didn't get along great in the past. How ironically named is Rosie O'Donnell? Is there anyone less Rosie?
I never thought of that, but yeah, not Rosie at all.
Yeah, if her mom named her bitch Cuntenstein, I would say you didn't go far enough.
Right.
You didn't go far enough.
Right. Cunty McShit for brains, something like that.
So I know, have you buried the hatchet with Rosie, President Trump?
Yeah, no, of course not. There's no burying.
Okay. This feels to me like Cardi B, because Cardi B speaks directly and simply like a 7-year-old with a learning disability. So I'm going Cardi B.
That was my first choice, but in the spirit of gamesmanship, who's the first person?
Vanessa Hudgens.
Sure, I'll go Vanessa Hudgens.
I think Cardi B the right answer.
You going Vanessa, Bryan?
Just for gamesmanship, because otherwise, you know, we'd pick the same one. So just to spice it up, I'll go Vanessa.
Okay.
I mean, clearly, it's a very stupid person. So I think I'm going to go with Adam's choice, Cardi B.
Cardi B.
The blog belongs to Cardi B.
Yeah.
For a three-way tie.
All right. Let's do a tiebreaker.
Text me. I know this can be hard, really hard. I joined community. My hope is that you feel like you can text me anytime about anything, always. Here's my number, 323-396-9923. Is it Rose McGowan?
Yeah.
Alyssa Milano?
Bah.
Or Mark Ruffalo?
Okay.
Donald,
I don't mind Mark Ruffalo. I love a good Mark Ruffalo movie, sure. He always looks like he just got divorced.
He does have that look. Did you like The Incredible Hulk?
Yeah, I love that. Mine's myself. I sort of rage in the White House like that. I rip my shirt and pants off, run around, break shit.
All right.
I'm like, Mr. Trump, that's a 100-year-old whatever the crap. And I go, I don't give a shit. Smash. Hey, Mr. Trump, Lincoln made that. I go, oh, really? It's up my butt right now. Spoosh. All right, anyway.
Man, I'm going to let you go first.
Oh, shit. Okay. This is an insane person, so I'm going to say Rose McGowan.
Rose McGowan. All right. Teresa?
I think I'm going to go with Alyssa Milano only because she's come up twice.
Interesting technique. President Trump?
They're both of that charm show. Remember that, Adam? Charmed.
Yeah.
That's ironic, too. It's like Rosie. It's like charmed. These two. I'm going to go with Fat Alyssa for the win.
Wait, who'd you go with?
Fat Alyssa.
You can't. You have to. That's one person?
Fat, yeah. Alyssa.
Oh, fat. Sorry. All right. I'll go Mark Ruffalo. Here we go.
For the win, the strategy paid off. The blog belongs to Alyssa Milano.
Oh,
congratulations, Teresa Strasser.
Yeah, Teresa Strasser. All right, let's bring it home.
Until next time, keep your fingers on your keyboards and your heads up your asses so we can play another round of Blah, Blah, Blah.
All right, I think we're going to close out the show with some Adam Carolla is Unprepared. So I want to give some plugs out where plugs are due. Kyle Dunnigan, everybody.
Hey, yo.
Kyle Dunnigan, comedy.com, and Instagram at Kyle Dunnigan 1, and Twitter at Kyle Dunnigan as well. Teresa Strasser, podcast Easy Listening with Gina Grad and Teresa Strasser. And the TV series The List, that is playing on stations across the country, so find it nearest you. And Bald Brian, thank you guys for tuning in. And I figure we'll do a round of Adam Carolla's Unprepared. You guys are going to raise your hands. You're going to shout out one word, and I'm going to do a comedy bit around that one word. So if you have a word, raise your hand right here. Vasectomy. Oh, yes. She just went full Kool-Aid on vasectomy. You want him to get a vasectomy. I don't know how the vasectomy works. I happen to like the tubes being tied more than the vasectomy. You know what I think they ought to do? You know how they have those new parties where we guess the sex of your baby? We take a ball and we put either pink powder in it or blue powder in it, and we toss it up to a major league ball player and he smacks it. If it's pink, you have a girl. If it's blue, you have a boy. We should do some version of that with vasectomy versus tubes tied. we should have like a piñata, and the piñata should be either filled with buttermilk or a bunch of tube socks tied in a knot. And we should have to figure it out. And also, I think you can reverse your vasectomy, by the way, which seems like a job to me to come in and reverse that. By the way, if I were a surgeon who specialized in reversing vasectomies, I'd have a very interesting conversation with the gentleman who came in, which was, Jesus, 10 minutes ago, you loved fucking and not having kids. Now, if your wife rolled over on your youngest or your middle, drowned in the pool, I'm all ears. But if you just decided you wanted to shit out a bigger brood, I'm not down with that. And I would be pitching if I was the surgeon, and you came in and you wanted a consult, and you're like, I want to talk about reversing my vasectomy. I'd be like one of those, you know, those people who stand in front of the Planned Parenthood, the religious people who stand in front and like, hey, look, you would take this pamphlet. Come on, Christianity is like, I'd be that as a doctor, except for my religion would be blowjobs. I'd be like, yeah, I could cut you open. It's pretty risky. Or you could get a nice Hummer. As a matter of fact, I happen to drive my custom van here today, and I don't let just anybody use it, but maybe you and the missus could blow off a little steam in the parking lot and get your head clear, come back, see if you're still gung-ho for the reversal of the vasectomy. How much is a vasectomy? It's like 800? How much? 500, is it covered by insurance? It is. You know, my feeling is when I'm in charge, I'm gonna be assigning a lot of vasectomies to a lot of fucking dudes in this land. But it is a good sign. It means you have a healthy relationship. It means you enjoy engaging in sex. And I also hear that after the vasectomy, the first time, that's the charm. That's the big one. That's why I've been thinking about getting a vasectomy, screwing once, going back, and constantly being in flux, constantly living in that place of the best load I've ever dropped, because I'm coming off the vasectomy. Yeah, I think I would be pitching blowjobs if I was the doctor in charge of the vasectomy reversals. And if you got a little like offended, I'd be like, well, fine, but there's a Greek doctor down the hall that's pitching a completely different plan. You think you're pissed now? Wait till you talk to him. All right, so I think we should flip the coin right now. I think we should decide the tubes tied versus the vasectomy. I know you want him to do that, and I know he wants you to do that. I feel like if we flip that coin right now, the coin would tell. Well, that's an interesting thought. Oh, we should play rock, paper, scissor, because the scissor is like the vasectomy. Yeah, heads or tails, either one, we don't need the vasectomy. All right, now hold on, your heads. Oh, we don't have a coin. This is weird. We have come to a place in life where people no longer use change. Someone is gonna find a coin. All right, we'll get you a coin. Yes, all right. Your heads over there, tails. So heads, vasectomy, Sorry, wait a second. Let's put it this way. Heads, tubes tied, vasectomy. Sorry, Jesus Christ. I feel like fucking Steve Harvey and it's the Miss Universe competition. Fucking this up royally. This is worse than Kimmel at the Oscars. Heads, tubes tied. Tails, vasectomy. All right, you ready? Here we go. It's official. What did it land on? All right, it just landed on the ground. This, by the way, this is why the terrorists hate us. Uh-oh, it's on the ground. Heads! All right. All right, yeah. All right. It's so it is written, so it is done. Now it's no 2 out of 3. Now hop up here. I've not performed any surgeries, but I've built a lot of model airplanes. So come on up. I don't see a huge chasm between the two endeavors. All right, let's do another one. Hands up. Put your hand up. You got one word for me to do a bit. Hopefully it won't. We just did yours, didn't we? You got another one? Come on, we got one there. There you go. Y'all. All right. I like y'all because it lets me know what part of the country you're from. So I'm from North Hollywood. Nobody says y'all. And then there are other parts where they say use guys, which seems like a lot more work than y'all. But I like that y'all come again here. I like that. And it's also code to I'm a little bit racist. So I usually have a couple of Jew jokes chambered, and I keep them close to the vest. But if I hear someone say y'all, I go, hey, have you all ever heard this one before? All right, let's do another one. I don't have that much on y'all. Right there, straight ahead. Loveline. What's that? Loveline. I'll do Loveline a second. She's raising her hand, drunken guy in the back. Sorry, I'm going up front. Yes. Yeah. Dick? Yeah. Dick. All right, I can do Dick. I was thinking about it the other day as a guy with a very average dick. I have an average dick. It's not small, it's not big, it's nothing to write home about. By the way, if you did have a huge dick, would you write home about it? Like, dear father and mother, I took out this quill and parchment to make you aware of something that I think you should know. I have a super big dick. But I was thinking about dicks 2 days ago. I was in my bathroom. And you know, you kind of think about that stuff, like so much is just sort of random luck of the draw. Like, you know, if you're a guy and your hair is thinning, or you're a girl, some girl have a big bosom, some have an A cup. Like it's all your nose, like your height. It's all random, right? It's all random. We give everyone credit for everything. Like, look at her. She's so beautiful. She's so tall. Look at her cheekbones. But it's really just cosmic roll of the dice, right? And isn't your dick size the ultimate cosmic roll of the dice, if you think about it? I've seen enough porn to know that the guy's dick size has nothing to do with male pattern baldness or his height or his biceps or his bank account or his FICO score. There's some dudes that just have a big dick and other dudes don't have a big dick. And I was just kind of thinking about what does it mean if you just have an average dick? And I thought, well, it means God doesn't care about you, you know? Like, when God is handing out the dicks, and not that he's physically handing the cocks, he's not gay, he probably farms that out to one of his lieutenants, but what I'm saying is God is handing out the dicks, and when he gives you a micro penis, that is a pox upon your loins and your family. But when he gives you a huge hog, that's the greatest gift God could give you. And when he gives you an average sized dick, he's basically just saying, move it along. He's like the bouncer in front of a club with the clicker and it's half capacity. Yeah, go ahead. Just a big black guy in a turtleneck with a huge dick just going, yeah, keep going. And sometimes I think about myself. I think, are you blessed? Are you lucky? Should you cash in and take it all to Vegas and just put it on red and spin that roulette wheel? And then I look at my dick and I think, don't leave the house. And sometimes I think about bungee jumping and then I look at my dick and go, not touched by the hand of God. I got the, who's next in the dick department? Move it along. Also, there seems to be no correlation between the size of your body and the size of your dick. Now, you women could probably tell me, but I once was hosting Loveline on MTV, and I was sitting next to a young black actress at the time, and I said on the air, I said something like, well, you know, maybe the guy doesn't have a small dick, but maybe he doesn't have a big dick. Maybe he's no Shaquille O'Neal in the loins. And everyone laughed. And then we went to commercial, and the young black actress leaned over to me during the commercial break and said, I've been with Shaq. It ain't all that. You don't see that in a general commercial, do you? By the way, when a hot black chick says she's seen Shaq's dick, you don't go, fucking liar. Let me smell your hand. You just go, what? And then there's that next thing that washes over all guys where we go, oh, good. Now, I have a theory about black men and big dicks. But I mean it. I've watched copious amounts of pornography, and I've seen many white guys with average-sized dicks in pornography. Maybe they know the director. I don't know how they made it in. But, by the way, do you think there are any guys who work, like they do say, and I mean it, I think it's probably about 30% of guys are like piss shy, like if they go into a ballpark and they're trying to take a piss and there's a dude standing next to them, they're like, I can't do it with this dude standing here. Do you think there are any male porn stars that are piss shy? Because that would be very complex in terms of their wiring. Like, you just dropped a load in this chick's hair with 11 people standing around. Then you went to the bathroom and the guy who holds the boom mic was standing too close to you and you went, come on, dude, I can't focus with you. That was a tangent. My point is this. Black guys in porn. Lots of average-sized white dude dicks in porn, I get it. Always black dudes with huge hogs in porn. So, because the average American has only seen the brother's dick in pornography, it's not like I played football at Grambling and I was in in showers just surrounded by black guys and their dicks. The only black dick I see is in porn, and they're always huge, and I think it's not because they're necessarily bigger. I think porn discriminates, and they'll let whitey in with a medium-sized honker, but if your brother, you gotta be hung like a rhino in order to break into the business, and when I'm in charge, I will put an end. I will be up on stage. I'll have Kamala Harris on one side of me and Cory Booker on the other, and I'll be looking right into that camera. Nation of Islam, bow ties, me talking about this has got to end. What was the question? What was it? Dicks? Dicks, yeah. Yeah. Well, next time, fellas, next time you're thinking about going to Vegas or hopping on that motorcycle without a helmet or doing something a little dangerous or cashing out and starting your own business, take a look at your junk. If it ain't huge, you might not be lucky. All right, let's do another. What do we got? Right there. I'm thinking a lot about dicks. That's my job. I was requested to think a lot about dicks. That's my job. Hey, you guys probably been, you been with one of those guys that's got a little English on his dick? Like, it starts out going straight, then heads toward Mecca. It's called Peyronie's disease, that's right. I don't know if there's any therapy for that dick, but if I'm a doctor, you've had that bent dick? Yes. My feeling, here's my therapy. If it goes to the left, you got to beat off with your right hand. It's just sound medical principle. If it goes to the right, you got to do your left hand. And if it goes down, you got to get the nanny to do it because haven't really worked that one out. You've been with a guy that had the curvature? Yeah. You got to now. Did it go up? Did it go down? Did it go Republican, Democrat? Down. Went down. Yeah. I talked to that dude. He said it was fine before he met you. He said it was good. No, you know what he said? He said, my dick was like an orca's fin in the wild, majestic, running free. Then I got with this witch and I went full blackfish. Just tipped over on me. No amount of herring or cod could ever get it to go straight again. You've seen those movies, the fucking Shamu's just going in a circle, all bummed out, tanks too small, no freedom, longs for the majesty of the open sea where he can swim freely and live again. No, going in a circle with his bent dorsal dick. I guarantee as soon as he hit open water, and when I say open water, I mean a 23-year-old receptionist at Bennigan's, that dick straightened right out again. You want full orca on his ass. That's a true story, people. I wish I was making it up. I may never say that again. It may have never been said before. But who is this guy? Is he gone? He's long gone. Oh, you got a 23-year-old with a straight dick? Nice. All right, good. Your last name is Dick. Ho, yeah. All right, let's do one more. Oh, wait, what do you got there? All right, let me hit a spot. Let me regain my composure here. Geico, yes, that's right. You need auto insurance. Everyone's doing their part these days. Geico wants you to know that they're going to share some with you. Geico, they have a give back program, 15% credit on car and motorcycle policies for current and new customers because Geico's committed for the long haul. The 15% credit lasts the full policy term. Visit geico.com/giveback for info and eligibility. All right, let's do one more. Right back there. What do you got? What is it? Sweet? Oh, queef. Oh. Come on, I'm a Christian. How dare you? I don't want, let's not go out on a weird vaginal noise. Did someone say Texas? I'll do Texas. I gotta say something. I grew up in California. I didn't know what Texas was. Texas, all I knew from Texas was the beginning of the Beverly Hillbillies. That's all I knew about Texas. Old Jed Clampett was shooting at some food, and up from the ground came a bubbling crude. Oil, that is. Black gold, Texas tea. And I thought, what is this weird place? It seems too hot, and Jed Clampett was fleeing Texas to go to Beverly Hills. I grew up in North Hollywood. North Hollywood is 7 miles away from Beverly Hills, so I'm like, all I gotta do is get from North Hollywood to Beverly Hills, and then me and Jed and Ellie Mae and Mr. Drysdale can all have fun in our cement pond, which he called the swimming pool. So I thought, all I gotta do is get from North Hollywood to Beverly Hills. Now, I made it to Beverly Hills, and I'm thinking, how the fuck do I get to Texas? Because at the end of the day, all I want to be is left alone to enjoy my freedom, which is why we all came to the United States in the first place. And maybe the Lone Star State is the place to do it. So maybe I'll just move into the green room and never leave again. Hey, I want to thank Kyle Dunnigan for coming out here tonight via Zoom. And you guys for coming out, being a great crowd tonight. Until next time, this is Adam Carolla. For Teresa Strasser, Bald Bryan, and Kyle Dunnigan, say it. Mahalo!
Keep it going forever!